Got a dream about the future. Where there was some kind of city being built around a grassland and a savanna. And a jungle nearby. And they didn't turn. And the river turned into their farmland. They had some sort of terraced farm. How absurd. What's not absurd is the fact that I am in desperate need of something to protect myself. I've grown sick of cowering from this world's monsters. A blade is as good a place as any to start. Sorry, cows. Not much leather gained from that. Only a 3. Well, at least I can repopulate those cows fairly simply. I could have sworn that I had a chest with extra bread in it. Well, I may as well put it in the plants chest. Goodness gracious. I need more coal and charcoal. And there goes my axe. I see. The other villager. Those citizens have been crafty. In golems. Stalwart protector. There's a of this settlement. That they are. If I may break character for a second, I'm just going to heat iron in this here. He says bronze, since I don't really have, well, actual bronze to use. So if any of you guys get confused when I say that, just refer to this. Just a generous supply of hand wavy. And if it bothers you too much, just repeat to yourself, it's just a show. You should really just relax. What I wouldn't give for a spear. And a shield. Actually, a shield sounds divine. I should make myself a shield. Soon I will cower no more. For I shall be protected by the flesh of beasts. And by the flesh of the oak. About half of the village still remains cloaked and dark during the night. That doesn't bode well. For our people to be safe, I will need to make more torches. And so, the torches shall be spread. There we go. All right. I spy a donkey. Yes, more flesh of beast to adorn myself with. Just enough now to make a pair of boots. Aha, but what do we have here? With any luck, I'll get at least one leather from each of these. Ooh, two from that one. Very good. Aw, none from that one? Really? And none from that one. Well, if I don't get two from this last one, then I'll be short. Excellent. There. Fully adorned with the hides of beasts. I am now much better equipped to deal with the horrors of night. Well, I better get back to mining. Bah. Goodness. My pick is already broken. It is a good thing that I have all the resources. A metal pick will serve me well from the depths. Not only have I failed to secure more metal, but now it is night. I hope no dark creature has have spawned within the village while I have been gone. A spider appears. I successfully defeated the giant arachnid, but there may yet be more. Aha! This is the sort of thing I was looking for. Almost there. Oh, you muppet. If you climbed over the city wall, well, you deserve whatever fate befalls you. The village is just now safe, at least on the inside. And now day is about to break. Now that I've ensured the safety of my fellow villagers, I think it might be time that I perhaps do a little exploring? Certainly the lands beyond the village, which must have more resources for us to take advantage of, but first, I'm going to need another pickaxe. I know it's in that general direction. That's where I came from, after all. But what about what over here? I don't know what's beyond those hills. Oh. Well, here's something to explore. Well, that was shockingly lame. Oh, what have we here? Barbarians? Thank the gods for shields. Never stood a chance. More of these horses. I suppose I don't need anything from them right now. I'm already fully clothed. The grassland seemed to go on forever. Right, googly moogly, it's almost sunset. Well, at least I'm confident that I can survive on my own, and at the village it shouldn't die without me. That's a nice looking beach. This area actually looks like it would be pretty good for a coastal city. Whoa! Ravines! My gods! And has set. Guess I'm doing this. Hello. Sea turtles. I had heard legends of these creatures. I thought they were a joke. Creature. Oh dear. Oh dear. Some sort of powder substance came from that creature. I wonder what this could be. Goodness gracious. There's so many out here. I'd have to be a fool to take on so many at once. Alright, let's take things a step at a time. Ah! The zombie dropped metal. This creature explodes. I'd best stay away from these. My sword is almost was depleted. I must return home. Post haste. Huh. I will not fall to the beast of the night. Not this night. Oh no. Even in the sea, there are monsters. And my sword is dead. In a spot like this, an axe will do. If I'm not rightly mistaken about where I am, if I should hug the coast, I should eventually be able to find my way back home. Oh dear. And these green creatures are so silent as well. They could creep up behind you and just end you. I'll call them exploding sneakers. No, that's dumb. I'll put a pin in that. I recognize that hill. That's where I mine. I'm almost home. Alright, just keep running. Maybe they won't be able to hit. I didn't know all this was so close to where I lived. So close to the village. And this is not, in fact, where I go to mine. Oops. That said, I shouldn't be too far. If I'm not like rightly mistaken, this might be the river that leads to home. Yes! I can see the palisade. Darn those ancient necromancers and heathens. If it is within my power, I will find and where the gods have gone, I will find them, and I will try to convince them to return. Dawn breaks. The creatures of the night shall soon be no more. I have survived. And so the primitive one was able to survive the night. And through his survival, he would learn more. And through learning more, he would become smarter and wiser. Tune in to see more of his struggles next time.